Hey guys, I'm the Seaman235, and yes, Zach, the camera is on.
I know that.
And your face is only half there. Now it's all there. Now there's like a portion of it missing.
Good.
Now none of it's there. So the Nintendo Switch presentation happened, and my reaction video is going to take a while because it's almost an hour long.
Let's cover the most anticipated game.
Well, before we talk about anything, let's go over our thoughts on the presentation, just quick summary, what we thought of it. I thought it was really good. Save for a few exceptions. Okay, would you rate it like an 8 out of 10 or a 7 out of 10 or a 9 out of 10 or a 10 out of 10 or
7,
something?
7, I don't know.
Alright, 7. I would go straight up an 8 or an 8.5. I think it was a really good conference, save for a few things that were wrong with it. I have a pen here. I know. Anyway,
$70 Pro Controller.
So now we can talk about the things about the Switch, specifically the price, the presentation, and the Joy-Cons.
And the first game announced.
And no, just those for right now. I will say, I'm gonna be honest, I'm still not feeling the Joy-Con.
Yeah.
I'm not feeling it. Like, they tried, they really tried, and I will admit some of the stuff it can do is impressive.
Maybe if they have some displays at stores, you could maybe see if it feels right for you.
Yeah, like before we actually made this video, we were playing Super Mario 3D World, because that was
a
gift.
It's a much better game one player.
Yeah. But
camera.
One of the things that I hate about, I hate about some Mario games, especially 2D ones, actually, I'd say more, is that they make mincemeats out of my hands when I'm using a really small controller, like the Wii Remote, or something like that.
Which one specifically? Mario Maker levels online?
Well, that's the thing, though. Even though you can use the Wiimote, I think you can. I've never had trouble with those, mostly because I've always had. Hell, and I just closed the page on me. I mostly never had trouble with it.
Yeah, I like the sideways.
With the Pro Controller. The Pro Controller was good.
I like the sideways Wii Remote for NES platformers.
The Pro Controller I usually use, and that's usually pretty good, but at the same time, I will admit, it does also make mincemeat because the D-pad is below the analog stick. And while that maybe work for some people, I'm gonna be honest, I like the way the DualShock controller does it.
I have to put up with that for the 3DS, and the D-pad for the 3DS I think is a bit
cheap.
I never
was bothered by it with the D-pad or the 3DS.
I'm not bothered by it, but it's just it feels cheap on the 3DS, honestly.
I never had a problem with it, honestly. I don't know what you're talking about, so. Sorry.
Maybe it's because I play games like Ninja Gaiden where I had to constantly switch from left to right.
Considering that controllers like that always made mincemeat out of my hand, how do you think those small little controllers, like you press a little...
You're going to get cramps.
You're going to get hand cramps. I also hate how it also makes the D-pad segmented. Like, you know how...
I haven't owned the Sony system ever, really.
The segmented, the D-pad
so
isn't
I'm not
segmented.
Used to, I'm not I'm used the, to the kind of...
No, it's not like the D-pad.
Wait, it's completely segmented?
Yeah, it's completely segmented. God. Mm-hmm.
How the hell are you going to play a...
That's why I'm buying a Pro Controller. God. Because it doesn't seem
that
like...
That sounds like a nightmare.
To be fair, it'll be good for taunts and Smash Brothers.
No. Yeah, because those are so hard to do.
Yeah.
Oh wait, no, well, they're not.
Except for when you do the wrong one.
Rest in peace. With a small-ass D-pad
on the GameCube controller.
Rest in peace, all side-scrollers and Metroidvanias.
You still have the Pro Controller.
Wait, is Bloodstained come into any Nintendo systems, or is it just PS4?
I'm going to assume it's probably going to come to the Switch at some point. It's going to take a little bit.
Because I don't know if it was kickstarted, like added to what it was added to. I know PS4 and probably Xbox One.
Yeah. Anyway, speaking of some of the stuff that you the $300 price you wanted to talk about, and also the fact that you have to pay for online now.
Yeah, the $300 price is like, I know the competitors have had their consoles out for a while, so they've been able to lower their prices, and they're probably still selling it at a loss. But it really sucks, though, that people are probably not going to be as willing to buy it because of that price. And the part of the appeal for the Wii wasn't just because it was casual for people, but it was also because of the price being so low, which
it was the cheapest.
Yeah, because it was cheap to produce because all they had was the just
It was a Super GameCube.
Yeah.
Not to mention
motion controls had it.
Not to mention that the 360, while definitely cheaper than the PS3 was at the time, it was also still pretty expensive.
And the 360
PS3
and the
was $600.
And the original white models was freaking obnoxious with its
Red Ring of Death.
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna ever get over that.
360s. I fucking 360.
I wish I returned my 360, even though it probably would have died again. And I blame it also on people in my family just being irresponsible and leaving shit on.
The $300 price, I think it's a fair compromise for the most part.
How much did the Wii U cost at launch, though?
The Wii U cost $350 for the deluxe model, $300 for the 8GB model, which I have.
And they're still only having 32 gigabytes at most, which is obnoxious.
And you have to buy a hard drive for the damn thing if you want to hold more than 6 games. For physical only. You're not going to be able to download even one.
Yeah, to download, you're not going to be able to hold those games. They're too massive.
You're not even going to be able to hold 2 games. You're only going to be able to hold one at most. Which is why you have to buy a hard drive. With a 32 gigabyte model, like, it'll be okay for like maybe 3 or 4, but only those 3 or 4. And there's a lot more games on the Wii U that are worth having than just 3 or 4. I can count 5 right now. Smash, Mario Kart 8, 3D World, Sonic Lost World, Bayonetta 2, Hyrule Warriors, that's 6. But still, you get the point.
I don't know if it would be a big deal for me if I had a Wii U, because I'd probably just, the only things I'd download mostly would be eShop, like...
If you're a virtual console downloader, you're really going to want that space.
But NES games and...
You're really going to want it.
I don't know how much SNES games though take up, but they're like under 10 megabytes.
You probably would want to get some rare Game Boy Advance games that you can't get or get bootlegs of all the time. So you're also going to want that.
Yeah, because eBay...
Wii U also only had one price drop.
I'm really annoyed of how I bought those two Zelda games for like $25 for...
Anyway, moving on. Fun fact though, the Wii U actually had one price drop. People always say it never had a price drop. It actually did. Not by terribly much though. You see...
Because of the Nintendo.
Yeah. The 32 gigabyte model was what became the main model for the Wii U. The 8GB model, I actually think, is a bit more expensive because no one bought it. So because of that, it did have a price drop of $50 only. So it's still $300, which is fucking stupid, Nintendo.
Yeah, Nintendo.
The best way...
How much they dropped the base price of the original Wii, though?
They dropped
ever
it by at least...
Ever maybe?
No, not 200, because it was 250 when it first came out.
Yes.
I think they dropped it by 100.
Oh.
That was it.
Yeah, but...
So it was 150, which is actually pretty good for a console.
Yeah,
but still.
But there were also other models, but they were not very great, because there was the one that...
Lack of GameCube support,
yes.
Mini...
And the GameCube, it basically has
it's
a lot
It's not actually that hard to get a Wii with GameCube support, thankfully.
Yeah.
It just, you know, because they mass-produced them pretty well.
Because the game...
Unlike PS3s that could play PS2
Because the Wii doesn't have that
games.
Many great games on it, really, per se.
It had Brawl, it had the Galaxy games,
it had
the Metroid Prime Trilogy.
It had Zelda.
And it had Zelda, Twilight Princess, and Skyward Sword, which I know is debatable for some, but some people like them.
Especially amongst the fan base.
And
it had Donkey Kong Country Returns.
I
think it's still a good game.
I don't like Donkey Kong Country Returns, so I I don't think it's a good game.
It's not your taste.
Maybe, but I didn't like that game. Despite what people shit on it all the time, New Super Mario Bros. Wii is a good game.
Yeah, it's good, even though it's not as good as the U one. But it's still fun.
If anyone says Mario Kart Wii, I will shove this in their eye. This thing right here.
It's not that, but it's just, Wii was just,
it's the third worst Mario Kart game, only behind Super Circuit and SNES Mario Kart.
Is Super Circuit the worst for you?
Well, the worst that I've played, yes. I haven't played the SNES one once.
I hope the drift is better in that one.
It's not. In fact, I don't even know, I don't actually think there is any drifting.
Well, hopefully the game's designed around it.
No, it's not. It really isn't, especially on SNES Rainbow Road.
Well, I guess you appreciate Mario Kart DS much more.
No, I appreciate Mario Kart 64 a lot more.
Okay.
And then I appreciate Double Dash, and then I appreciate DS, but I especially appreciate Double Dash, because Double Dash is awesome.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway...
Except for the fact that it only has 16 courses.
Well, that was Mario Kart Standard for the longest time.
Well, no, Super Circuit had 32 still.
Yeah, but
even though
Super
the other
Circuit,
ones were a pain in the
Super
ass
Super Circuit played like
they were really they were a real pain in the ass to get because you had to collect 100 coins in like the course after you complete it. I think it was
something like that.
Yeah, it's really.
I may actually go down my way to do that one day though.
Don't try 100% the game truly because you have to get like triple star ranks.
Yeah, okay, you just convinced me. Fuck that.
Yeah.
Anyway, moving on. In general, the $300 price, I'd say, is a fair compromise. I think it really should have been $250, personally. I understand why they're not doing that. I understand why, because it's the tablet. That's probably at least
$50
on the price tag.
Yeah, but to get families to buy a system, you
and then there's the Joy-Cons, which is probably another $50. And
$80 if you want two of them, because they're so magnificent.
Right. Or what you could do is you could just buy a pro controller because those are the controllers you're most likely going to use. Yeah. And I'm going to be honest, I'm getting a pro controller, so that's going to jack up the price to at least a $50 to other
hey, Cody,
dollars.
Maybe there will be a bunch of third-party ones trying to capitalize. Now.
And also, 32 gigs.
Do you think
it's 32 gigs again?
Yeah.
Thankfully, I will say this. The method of storage is better. Instead of buying a USB hard drive, a USB desktop hard drive, instead what you have to do, and it has to be a desktop hard drive, it cannot be an external hard drive. I learned that the hard way. But when it comes to the source of memory that you can put in, you can use SD cards. Like the big ones, not the crappy.
How do you eat up so much memory? Like what do you download? Like just the DLC from both Smash and like,
the DLC from Smash?
Yeah, it's
Smash
not much.
Brothers, it's, no, the DLC from Smash. Even if you have a physical copy, takes up so much memory.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's not the characters specifically.
The characters, the
it's
meme
more.
Fighters,
it's more so
the
update.
Updates.
No, it's more so the updates. The update's the main thing.
No, it's also the DLC, too. The DLC takes a lot more than the updates do. Because the DLC is actual content. The updates, it's just minor patches and changes. You know, it does contain data for the characters, but not all of it. At the same time, Mario Kart 8 also had DLC. And then there was also downloadable games that I had, like Freedom Planet, which I'm not probably going to start over.
Aren't you proud that you got that instead of Shovel Knights?
No, because, you know, I got to try it out, you know?
Oh, yeah, you better get Shovel Knight before spring, because the price is going to jack up a bit, because they're trying to split it up into smaller parts, and the full experience you can buy also. The price is going to be going up.
Well, that's not going to happen anytime soon, so...
Yeah, it's worth spring, I think it is, so you should get it beforehand.
Well...
It's well worth...
I'm going to be honest, I'm probably not going to do that because I'm going to have to save up for the Switch.
Yeah.
Because I'm buying it, I'm buying it. Not day one, but I'm buying it.
Yeah, the game is pretty... Shovel Knight's pretty good.
So, yeah. Also, the fact that you have to pay for online, another thing. Thankfully, it's free until
you get you get an NES or SNES game with it for a month. Thanks, Nintendo.
It is going to be free. I'm going to assume there's also going to be a free trial, like Sony has that. I don't know if Microsoft does. Maybe they do. I don't think
Microsoft does.
Because I still haven't used my free trial
Microsoft
yet.
Does
I
their,
still have an option
does
for
a similar thing to Sony, right? With their subscription, only not as good, I guess. Not quite.
Yeah, well, it wasn't as good, and I don't think it ever will be, but Sony jacked up the price
still,
of it by $10.
For a year, though, right?
No.
For a month?
No.
What?
They jacked up the price of both, I believe, for $10.
Hmm.
There was no additions, no benefits, no anything like that. It was just jacked up to $10 for no reason. A lot of people assume it's because Sony, other parts of Sony aren't doing well. Like, the Ghostbusters movie that came out last year was a fucking flop. And then there was other Sony movies like Amazing Spider-Man 2. There was the hack that happened. And Annie didn't do well.
Man, they only sold over 50 million consoles in...
You
want to
know what you guys could have done? You could have waited for Spider-Man Homecoming and Civil War. Those made lots of money, and they do get a portion of that money.
I wonder, when's that movie coming out?
Spider-Man Homecoming's coming out this year.
Yeah, do you think the game's going to come with it around that time, probably? They're going to try that to capitalize?
I'm going to assume so, but
hopefully
let's... we're off topic. We're going to go back on topic. Good. During the 16 minutes, we've gone off topic at least six times.
We've been talking about the competitors now.
Yeah. Well, to be fair, it is important, because they're competing against them.
Mm.
But anyway, Let's actually talk about the online service. Apparently, there's going to be some kind of app for it on your phone or smart device. I'm wondering what that's about. I don't understand what that's supposed to be about. Like, well, I'm sure they'll explain more details. I'm hoping it's something, a replacement for Club Nintendo, because Miitomo or My Nintendo, both of those things failed.
Miitomo is basically a graveyard. It's been one since, like...
a while now. Yeah. And My Nintendo, honestly, I heard was even worse.
I tried making an account, basically, to get into My Nintendo.
My Nintendo, I heard, was terrible.
What was bad about it? It just
lacks even more than Club Nintendo did. Mm. And that was saying a lot, since Club Nintendo, honestly, wasn't that very good
customer
either.
Service.
No, not just customer service.
Deals.
More just like, I just heard the benefits weren't that
good. Yeah, that's what I mean.
And the benefits were limited for some reason.
They don't really reward you that much.
Yeah. But on brighter side of things, thankfully you can use SD cards to add to the memory, which is good because SD cards are dirt cheap. Well, SD cards are pretty cheap. Like, yeah. I got the one I'm using for my camera is actually a 16 GB one, which I know is peanuts for a game device. But you can get ones for like $60. You can get ones that are over like 100 GB or something like that.
I'm worried about how the Switch will sell, also because it's very underpowered.
And another thing, actually,
Sony and Microsoft are coming out with their new. Well, Sony already came out with their new model, but Microsoft is coming out with theirs this year, I think.
A part of me thinks it's the tablet functionality that's
even weaker. Yeah, that's...
And honestly, I think it can still do it for a little while, because I'm pretty sure that this console...
I don't know.
Going to only be used for this generation.
It could turn out to be just a gimmick.
It's not
going to
last longer than that.
It could be just a gimmick that doesn't really work out all that much, because the battery life isn't that great from what we've heard about so far.
But the lineup that they're having for the start of it is actually much better than the lineup for the Wii U.
Well, that doesn't say much.
It's better than the one for the Wii too, so.
what do we have besides Twilight Princess at launch?
And
Shovelware. Did it have...
I don't know.
When did Metroid Prime 3 come out?
I think it came out like a year afterward.
Oh.
Actually, I don't know. So why don't we just talk about the games? Clearly, I don't see anything. Actually, let's talk about some disappointments with and just bad things about the conference. Just get them out of the way. First off, the fucking translator. You said it earlier in the video. The fucking translators were fucking. They were smoking. There you go. Alright, there you go. Anyway, back to what we were saying. The translators were fucking stoned, because seriously, oh my god, they sounded so fucking bored. Like No More Heroes, when that was announced, the translator fucked up. It looked like he fell asleep for a little while. I guess it's better to look like you're falling asleep rather than actually falling asleep. Square.
What'd they do?
I think it was in 2015, their translator actually fell asleep.
Mm.
That was funny.
Nice. What was the dorm? Final Fantasy VII Remake.
I think it was from Kingdom Hearts.
What
actually?
If it was during the Final Fantasy VII Remake?
It was that and Kingdom Hearts.
Oh, Kingdom Hearts, of course, because they don't care about Kingdom Hearts. That's why they have took this long to make a third game they're taking.
Yeah. Anyway, the translators were awful.
A third numbered one, at least.
The translators were awful. Like, they sounded so bored. They sounded so bored. It's like, hey.
At least we didn't have a Ubisoft.
Super Mario
Odyssey. At least we didn't have a Ubisoft party.
This game is going to be released around holiday of 2017.
Cody, it could have been worse.
Ugh.
At least we didn't have a Ubisoft party.
On to the next line.
At least Ubisoft didn't advertise their Just Dance game.
Next up, we have...
Red Dead Redemption! No. Two Switch. Damn it!
We have No More Heroes.
No, One Two Switch. Oh, you're... Oh.
Travis will strike back. Seriously, he sounds so fucking bored!
Remember... that great final boss to No More Heroes 2? What do you mean it wasn't good?
What do you mean it was borderline unplayable?
What do you mean you don't like getting knocked out of a window?
What do you mean it was like Dark Gaia only for No More Heroes?
I don't know if it was
and tons short and tons shorter.
People just didn't like the personality of the villain, I think.
I heard the final boss was pretty terrible.
Well,
like, in general.
Because you get knocked out of the window and instantly killed by that?
Yep.
And that he's annoying?
Yep. So what were your other disappointments?
One, Two, Switch. some people in the comments, oh, it's going to be Red Dead Redemption 2. No.
Actually, at first I thought that too. I was like, wait, is this like a parody of Red Dead Redemption?
I wish it was.
No.
Sadly, we can't get good things. The only good games we're gonna get are gonna be first party ones.
And obviously, this is the obvious one. And I call me a fucking fanboy, but if you want, but no Smash Brothers.
Yeah, Smash is a system seller.
They're probably saving it. Honestly, I think they're saving it for E3. Or, well, actually, you know what? What I think they should do is around the time of E3, not on E3, but around that time, they do what they did with the Nintendo Directs. And they made a Nintendo Direct, a Smash Direct, and then they announced maybe Ice Climbers, and that's really it. And then afterwards, they announced Smash Brothers Switch, saying, hi, I'm Sakurai, which I'm speaking as a translator here. Hi, I'm Sakurai, and yeah, we're back to this again, only this time on a brand new console.
And we cut out
Sonic. The Nintendo Switch has been something we've been very proud of, and so far it seems to be doing well. Assuming. With that said, is a new character.
And we cut out Sonic to replace him with everybody's favorite character, Bubsy.
They're not going to cut out Sonic. They're never going to cut out Sonic. Not. I think Sega knows that they get a decent portion off of Smash Brothers 2 because he's in the game. So yeah.
And there are crappy Mario and Sonic games.
Well, not all of them are crappy.
For the most part.
First one was crappy though. I'll give you that.
What's the best one? The winter one?
No.
Oh.
A lot of the games I heard were the same. But anyway, speaking of games, let's talk about them. Starting with 1-2 Switch.
That's a $60 game, right? And you don't even do much with the console? Like, did you see any of the Treehouse? Because I didn't bother.
I saw the Treehouse for Breath of the Wild, Odyssey, and...
Oh, for... Wait, whoa, they showed Odyssey?
I think that... I don't know if they did. No, it wasn't Odyssey, it was something else. I'm pretty sure they would show at least a bit of it off. It seemed like they had something. Well, we'll have to see later on. I know I saw Mario Kart, Breath of the Wild, and
Splatoon 2.
Yeah, Splatoon 2, which the interface looks a lot better. But yeah, 1-2 Switch. Come on.
I think that game.
It's the Wii Sports Nintendo Land. 1-2 Switch. Seriously, how much you want to bet that when the toe screen pops up?
I hope it gets
1-2 Switch.
I hope it gets a lower. I hope it gets a lower Metacritic score than Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric.
Oh come on, don't be that harsh.
Okay, it'll get something probably around it. It's gonna get below 50.
It's at least probably gonna get a 7.
No.
I'm sure 1-2 Switch.
Are you fucking kidding me? No, it's not.
Alright, well then why what scores did Nintendo Land get?
Better than that, because it was at least a game.
And, yeah, I 1-2 Switch is a game, too. It's a launch title game.
And it's...
It's probably going to come with the system, I'm going to assume.
No, I don't know. I'm pretty sure they said that there's no game come with the system unless you get one of the bundles, like the Breath of the Wild one. Which you'll get a great Master Sword, a plastic cheap Master Sword thing.
When you could get just one of the phone ones that are actually a lot better. You know, something like the Nerf Swords I have over there.
Hmm.
With that said, 1-2 Switch looks alright. It does not look that bad. Honestly, I don't think it's gonna be that bad. It's gonna be the Wii Sports Nintendo Land where it's played about for a week and then it's just completely forgotten about.
Wii Sports was played for more than a week.
Fine, Wii Sports was played for a month. There. Anyway, 1-2 Switch looks fine. What I'm more interested in is the next game they showed after that is ARMS, which is probably going to be a tech demo, but it looks fairly interesting. Mm. It looks fun. It kind of looks like...
It's not something I would buy, though, unless it was, like, really cheap and it was a surprise hit, maybe, hopefully.
Looks like Punch-Out!
Except for the fact that Punch-Out is completely different because Punch-Out's primarily focused on single-player and there's personality.
Could you imagine
a shitty Punch-Out?
They actually replaced Punch-Out?
It's not going to. Punch-Out's either... That series
Well, let's be honest here. It's pretty much it's pretty much boxing, only you're far away and you're using extended arms.
Yeah,
it looks fun,
though. From what I've heard, it's not much more complicated than Wii Sports boxing, which is an issue.
It looks fun though. I'm gonna be honest. I don't know if I'm gonna get it unless it goes. I'm pretty sure they know it's gonna go around for at least 20, or maybe it's gonna be like Wii Play, where it's a game that really should only be worth $10, but they
people just bought
it. No, it's $60 because there's a free pro controller in there. I would actually like it if there was a pro controller. I would buy it along with the game because hey, it's $10 more. It's not that bad. So, and the art style looked really cool because it reminded me sort of like
Overwatch.
No, it reminded me more of Splatoon, and actually, what was it? What was that one game that the people who made Beautiful Joe made for the Wii U? It was,
Wonderful 101.
Yeah, it reminded me of that a lot, too, actually.